Here's a trick to memorize common polyatomic ions using the sentence Nick the camel ate clam supper in Phoenix with breath. The word ate represents that all the polyatomic ions in this trick have ate ending. The underlined letters represent the symbols of the first elements in the polyatomic ions. The consonants represent the number of oxygen atoms in the polyatomic ions. Lastly, the number of vowels represent the number of negative charges of the polyatomic ions. Now, the purpose of this trick is to memorize the number of oxygen atoms and the negative charges in the polyatomic ions. So you will need to know that each word in the sentence represent a certain polyatomic ions. For instance, nicked represent nitrate. The underlying N represent the element symbol N. Now, the word nick has three consonants in it, 1, 2, 3, so therefore it's going to be 3 oxygen. The word nick has 1 vowel, so therefore it's going to be 1 minus. Next, we have camel for carbonate. The word camel has a letter C underlying, so it's going to be carbon. Now, camel has 3 consonants, so it's going to be 3 oxygen atoms. It has 2 vowels, so it's going to be 2 minus. Next one, we have clam. Clam is for chlorate, so the CL underline that represents chlorine. And the word clam has 3 consonants, so therefore it's going to be 3 oxygen. And it has 1 vowel, so therefore it's going to be 1 minus. Next, we have the word supper represent sulfate. The word supper has S underlined that represents sulfur. It has 1, 2, 3, 4 consonants, so it's going to be 4 oxygen. And it has 2 vowels, so it's going to be 2 minus. Then we have phoenix represent phosphate. The underlying P in phoenix represent phosphorus. The word phoenix has 4 consonants, 1, 2, 3, 4, that represent 4 oxygen atoms. It has 3 vowels, so therefore we have 3 minus. Lastly, we have brad. Brad represents bromate. The BR underlined that would be bromine. It has 3 consonants, so it's going to be 3 oxygen. And it has 1 vowel, so it's going to be 1 minus. Now, if you know the 8 ending, you also know the polyatomic with the I ending, because the IT ending has 1 less oxygen than the 8 ending. For instance, nitrite is coming from nitrate. In this case, nitrate has 3, so in this case we have NO2, 1 minus. For chloride, it's going to be from chlorate. In this case, instead of having 3 oxygen, we just have 2 oxygen, and the charge remains the same. Sulfite is coming from sulfate. We have SO3 instead of FO4, and the charge would be the same. Phosphite is coming from phosphate. In this case, instead of 4 oxygen, it's going to be just 3 oxygen, and the charge stays the same. Now, going down here, we have a hydrogen polyatomic ion. That means the hydrogen is being added in to the polyatomic ion. So we have carbonate right here, right? Carbonate is CO3 2 minus, but when you add in the hydrogen, this hydrogen is H1 plus, so the charge is going to add a positive charge. In this case, we have HCO3, but it's no longer 2 minus, because we add 1 plus, it's going to be 1 minus. Here we have hydrogen sulfate instead of, like this, HSO4, instead of 2 minus, we are going to have 1 minus, because the hydrogen add a plus 1 charge to it. Then lastly, we have hydrogen phosphate. Phosphate is PO4, 3 minus, but with the hydrogen, it's going to be PO4, it's not 3 minus anymore, it's going to be 2 minus.